Kampala Metropolitan Deputy Police Spokesperson Luko Isejire has confirmed the death of 15-year-old student Kiza Melissa Catherine in a tragic fire that swept the Rukisani 2 zone in Kamocha, Kampala today morning. Melissa's remains were recovered in one of the raised houses and taken to Mulago City Mortuary for post-mortem. According to police, the fire broke out at around 1:49 a.m., engulfing several makeshift structures built from timber and iron sheets and causing extensive destruction of property in the area. He revealed that the emergency responders, including the police fire prevention and rescue services, acted swiftly to contain the fire with the support of a team from the Uganda Red Cross and a scene of crime officer. The affected residents have called on the government to provide relief items such as food, clothing and shelter. Area chairperson Israel Musazi spoke about the incident and the state of the residents. Authorities are continuing to comb through the scene to ensure no additional persons remain trapped and to gather evidence. According to police, investigations have commenced to determine the cause of the fire.
Ebintu ebibalirwamu obukade n'obukade bwa ssente bibayidde naye n'omwana omu mwana ono alina emyaka 15 afiriddemu.
The International Crimes Division of the High Court of Uganda, sitting in Gulu High Court Circuit in Gulu City today, Friday 25th October 2024, sentenced the former Lord's Resistance Army LRA Commander Thomas Kwoyelo to 40 years imprisonment. The court, however, gave Kwoyelo various jail terms for each of the 44 offences he was found guilty of, but it determined the 40-year jail term for the charges of murder as the proper jail term to reflect on his overall criminality. But the 15 years he spent on remand was deducted from the 40-year jail term, leaving him with a total of 25 years to serve in prison, effective October 25, 2024. According to Justice Michael Ebulu, the accused Kwoyelo has been sentenced to 30 years imprisonment for kidnap with intent to murder in counts 5, 6, 8, 10, 11 and 12, contrary to section 243 subsection 1A of the Penal Code Act.
In count 72, all sorts of offences arising out of the Pagaka tank, the convict was found guilty of the offence of cruel treatment as a violation of Article 31A of the Common to the Geneva Conventions.
Ebulu also added that the court shall conduct separate proceedings addressing the claims of reparations. He directed the victim's lawyers to make a formal application in which the Attorney General shall be joined as a party. Kwoyelo's lawyer Caleb Alaka said that they will appeal against the conviction and sentencing and that they will submit a formal notice of appeal within the stipulated period. The United Nations has issued a stark warning in its latest emissions gap report, with Secretary General Antonio Guterres urging world leaders to act decisively to avert a climate catastrophe. Guterres warned yesterday as a UN report said current climate policies will result in global warming of more than 3 degrees Celsius by the end of the century, more than twice the rise agreed to nearly a decade ago in Paris.
The message of today's emissions gap report is clear. We are teetering on a planetary tightrope. Either leaders bridge the emissions gap or we plunge headlong into climate disaster, with the poorest and most vulnerable suffering the most. This report shows annual greenhouse gas emissions at an all-time high, rising 1.3% last year.
The call to action, which comes just weeks before the UN COP29 climate summit, follows a streak of destructive and deadly extreme weather in a year, expected to be the hottest in recorded history. The world's poorest have been particularly hard hit, with typhoons and heat waves in Asia and the Caribbean, floods in Africa, and droughts and wildfire in Latin America.